Okay, engine compartment, part A. Clear lights, proper amber color, no crack, no broke, no damage, no missing bolts, and properly mounted and secured to the cabin. Windshield, properly mounted and secured to the cabin, no crack, no broke, no damage, no illegal stickers. I have one sticker, but this is totally legal and it's for the inspection. The wipers, they are properly mounted and secured to the cabin, and the rubber is in good conditions. No cuts, no missing parts, and no losing parts. The mirrors are properly mounted and secured to the door and the cabin. No crack, broke, or damage. Clean, no missing bolts, no missing nuts. In both sides. And yes, you need to check both sides. You don't do that, you only have half point. So, mirrors properly mounted and secured to the door and the cabin. No missing bolts or nuts. No crack, broke, or damage, and clean. Now, I go to the hood. The hood is properly mounted and secured to the frame. No holes, no dent, and it's in good conditions. Noise mirror, properly mounted and secured to the hood. No missing bolts or nuts. No crack, broke, or damage, and clean. The side grille and the front grille, properly mounted and secured to the hood. No missing bolts, no crack, no broke, no damage. And I don't see any obstructions. And I check the three of them, the side grills and the front grill. Then, the headlights. Headlights, proper clear color, properly mounted and secured to the hood, in both sides, no crack, no broke, and no damage. Signal lights, proper amber color, properly mounted and secured to the hood, no crack, no broke, no damage, in both sides. And you touch the piece, okay? Bumper, properly mounted and secured to the frame, no missing bolts. This is plastic, no crack, no broke, no damage, and it's in good conditions. License plate, properly mounted and secured to the bumper, bolts are present and tight, no illegal stickers, it's clean and visible. I don't see any leaks. I don't see any puddles, and my truck is on level and not leaning to one or the other side. Now, I check the latches. The latches are properly mounted and secured to the hood and the cabin. No crack, no broke, no damage in both sides. You need to check the other one and you need to open, okay? No crack, no broke, no damage. Properly mounted and secured to the from the hood to the cabin, and it's in good condition. Now I open the hood. I put my two hands here, and I catch with this one, and I do like this. If you're doing well, you have an extra point. Now I go to the engine. Okay, I start always up to down. And back to front. So I start with this one. This one is the AC blower. Properly mounted and secured to the cabin. It's plastic. No crack, no broke, no damage, no missing bolts. The wires are properly attached. No fray, no cut, no damage. The AC drive is properly mounted and secured to the cabin. No missing bolts. The hoses are properly attached. And I don't see any cuts. No bubbles and no leaks. It's in good conditions. Okay? Air ducts are properly mounted and secure. I don't see any leaks, cuts. All the clamps are present and tight. And then I go here to the turbo. The turbo is properly mounted and secure to the engine. It's metal. No illegal wears, no illegal repairs. This one right here, exhaust. The exhaust is properly mounted and secured to the turbo. Clamp are present and tight. And I don't see any dent, hole, or black dots that indicate leaks. Okay, I finished with this section. And now I go to the oil. This is the oil filter. It's properly mounted and secured to the engine. It's tight and no leaks. Now I take out this one. It's the dipstick. the dipstick is properly mounted and secure. I take it out, I clean, I put it back, I take out again, and I show that it's in proper level and the oil is in good conditions. I put it back and I finish. Now I go here. This one right here is the AC compressor. AC compressor is properly mounted and secured to the engine. It's belt driven. The belt is no more than 3/4 inch of free play. Wires properly attached. No fray, no cut, no damage. The hoses are properly attached. No leaks and no cuts. They are in good conditions. This one right here, alternator. Alternator is properly mounted and secured to the engine. It's belt driven. Belt is no more than 3/4 inch of free play. Wires are properly attached. No fray, no cut, no damage. Okay, I follow this hose and I arrive to the water pump. Water pump is properly mounted and secured to the engine. It's also belt driven and the belt is no more than 3/4 inch of free play. I finish with this and I follow the hoses. The hoses are properly connected or properly attached. I don't see any leaks, no cuts, and no bubbles. Clamps are present and tight. And you're right here. Radiator. Radiator is properly mounted and secured to the frame. No missing bolt. This one right here is the fan cover. The fan cover is plastic. No crack, broken, damage. No missing bolts or nuts. And it's in good conditions. I go here, and this is the fan. The fan is plastic. No crack, no broke, no damage. No missing any blends. And it's in good conditions. I go here and I check the fan clutch. The fan clutch is properly mounted and secured to the engine and the fan. It's belt driven and the belt and 3/4 inch of free play. Okay, I finish in this side. I just missing this one. That is the frame. The frame is not dent, no holes, no illegal welds, no illegal repairs, and no missing bolts or nuts. Okay, I go to the other side and I check the passenger side. Remember, you always need to check first the passenger side and then you check the driver's side. This one right here is the air filter. Air filter, this case is metal. No illegal welds, no illegal repairs, no dent and no holes. The filter is clean. Okay, now I go inside right there and it's the starter. Right down. The starter is properly mounted and secured to the engine. Wires are properly attached. No fray, no cut, and no damage. This one right here is the fuel pump. The fuel pump is properly mounted and secured to the engine. It's gear driven. The hoses are properly attached. The wires properly attached. No fray, no cut, and no damage. This one right here is the air compressor. Air compressor is properly mounted and secured to the engine. No missing bolts, no leaks, all the wires properly attached, all the hoses properly attached, no fray, no cut, and no damage. This one right here is the air governor. Air governor is properly mounted and secured to the cabin, all the hoses properly attached, no cuts, and no leaks. Okay, now I go down here. This is the steering pump. Steering pump is properly mounted and secured to the engine. It's gear driven. No missing bolts, no illegal welds, no illegal repairs, and it's in good conditions. Hoses are properly attached. No cuts and no leaks. I follow this hose and I arrive here to the power steering reservoir. It's plastic, no crack, no broke, no damage. It's proper level, cap present and tight, and the clamp are present and tight. Okay? I go there and I follow this hose and I arrive here to the steering box or gear box. It's properly mounted and secured to the frame. No illegal welds, no illegal repairs, and it's in good conditions. I go here and I check the U-joints. U-joints are properly mounted and secured. No crack, no broke, no damage. No illegal welds, no illegal repairs, and full grease. I check this one right here, the steering column. The steering column is properly mounted and secure, not dent, no illegal welds, no illegal repairs, and at least no more than 10 degrees of free play. Okay, I go down This one right here is the Pitman arm. This one is the drag link. Upper control, lower control, and the tie rod all are properly mounted and secured with these castle nuts and cutoff pins. Okay? Now I finish with the steering and I go to the suspension. Okay? This one right here is the leaf spring handles. Properly mounted and secured to the frame, no missing bolts or nuts, in front and back. Okay? Then I check the leaf springs. Leaf springs are properly mounted and secured to the leaf spring handles. No illegal welds, no illegal repairs, it's metal. This one right here, the U-bolts. U-bolts are properly mounted and secured from the saddle to the axle. It's in good conditions and no illegal welds, no illegal repairs. The axle is properly mounted and secure, no illegal welds, no illegal repairs, and not dent. Okay, and the shock absorber. The shock absorber is properly mounted and secure, up and down, no dent, and no leaks. Now I go to the brakes. That's the air hose for the brakes. They are properly mounted and secure from the fitting to the brake chamber. No cuts and no leaks. This one right here is the ABS line. It's properly mounted and secure. This is wired. No fray, no cut, and no damage. Okay, I arrive here to the brake chamber. The brake chamber is properly mounted and secure, and not dent, no leaks, and the clap are present and tight. This one is a push rod, and this one right here is a slack adjuster. And I mentioned both together, okay? The slack adjuster and the push rod, no more than 1 inch of free play with the brake release. Now, I go inside the tire, and I check the brake drum and the brake leanings. Brake drum is no dent, no illegal welds, no illegal repairs. The brake leaning of the brake shoes, at least 1/4 inch of thickness. And in between, no debris, no oil, no grease, okay? I check the tire in both sides, and I check like this, okay? No bubbles, no abrasions, no cuts, and no leaks. It's in good condition. I check the rim, and again, I check both sides, like this, and I check that it's not dent, no illegal welds, no illegal repairs. It's in good condition. All the lug nuts are present and tight. No shiny lines, no shiny metal that indicate lugness. The oil hub is properly mounted and secure, no missing bolts, proper level, cap is present and tight, and I don't see any leak.